And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek The Next Generation, The Final Unity. Blind. That's a mouthful, isn't it? Okay, I believe we've found this thing that is responsible for the attack on the station, possibly. Unless this is... we're at Merton's Orbital Station, by the way. Unless this is one of these experimental things they're working on, but it doesn't look like it's doing anything constructive. Thoughts? Everybody?
Life support will fail if we don't get it stabilized soon. Once it fails, we won't have much time.
I can't just let that woman suffer. We have to find a way to get her free.
Yeah, using the phasers killed her. I don't want to try that again.
If we revive the injured woman, she may be able to tell us about the attack.
Yeah, she couldn't speak.
The only person I've seen so far is that woman we found earlier.
Alright, so... one thing we should definitely do... is analyze this thing. So it's got iron, silicon, water, crystalline, and 4% unidentifiable compounds, less than 1% each of gold, iridium, hydrogen, sodium compounds, carbon compounds, and lead. Trace amounts less than 0.1% of many inert elements and compounds. Energy none. Analysis subject is naturally occurring interplanetary debris. What?
It's... wait a minute. I had readings of neutronium hull and internal energy, but now all I can pick up are natural elements.
What?
It's sending false readings to our tricorders.
Ooh.
It's like a chameleon. It
wow.
disguises itself perfectly. If we weren't here to see it, we'd never know it was here. It could probably fool our ship sensors just as easily.
Interesting. Well...
this chameleon field seems to take a fraction of a second to adjust to new scanning frequencies. If I set the tricorder to randomly shift frequencies at high speed...
good idea.
There. I'm getting a partial reading now.
Yeah, that was weird. I thought I was pointing at the wrong thing before. Okay. Surface is neutronium, minimum thickness 5 centimeters, deeper scan impossible. Maximum energy, maximum output estimated at 9.6, warp equivalence, duration 10 minutes, reserves increasing. Emissions, plasma suspension beam, active scanner waves. Warning, evidence of phaser capability. Analysis, subject is warp capable device, origin unknown.
Yep, it's a neutronium hull all right, and a powerful energy source. I've never seen that much power in such a small package before.
Mm-hmm. What a package, huh?
Amazing. It's using a plasma suspension beam to draw energy straight out of the main conduits.
I've never seen anything like it.
She said that before.
I'd say we've found our intruder.
He said that before.
I believe this is one of the attackers. There are weapon ports on both sides of its hull.
Try to talk to it?
That will not work.
Okay, try to take it out. We're on stun. Oh, this is the highest setting. Wait. No, these are low settings. You figured the red would be higher. Higher. Oh. Oh, so we'll all do it and die.
It didn't work. Commander Riker has been wounded.
Uh-huh. And Worf?
Worf's been injured.
Well, I should be using Crusher on them.
Wheels wounded. Worf's been wounded.
She wasn't much help. Use the medkit. I'm just unfamiliar with these controls. Oh, you're okay now?
There's no need for that. There's no...
well, let's look again. Tricorder medkit.
Wheels wounded. Worf's been wounded.
Okay, so they're wounded... but there's no need to use the medkit on them.
There's no need for that.
Righto. Okay. Evidently, we can't defeat this with conventional means.
There's no need for that.
No need to try to talk to it either. Used strange machine.
It's not working.
It looks like it's working to me. Okay, I don't think there's anything we can do with this right now. There's a turbo lift. Is this the same turbo lift or are these two different ones? Engineering Lab 4. Let's go to Engineering Lab 4 then.
Okay, what now?
I can't help thinking about that woman we saw earlier. We've got to help her.
Okay, well, I figure we might find something to help her in Engineering Lab 4.
You're right. Besides, she may be able to help us figure out what happened here.
Probably weren't supposed to go in here. She's probably gonna go back and she'll be dead or something. Equipment card.
There's nothing unusual here.
Wave converter?
There's nothing unusual here. There's nothing on you.
Uh-huh. Well, we've got all this equipment.
We do not have sufficient weaponry to destroy the intruder.
What is it doing here?
It appeared to be drawing plasma from the third conduit cluster.
Well, that's it. It's collecting energy. Maybe if we can temporarily shut off the power, it'll leave.
Maybe with one of these devices.
Make it think the wells run dry, eh? It's worth a try.
There should be emergency shutoff controls around here somewhere.
Okay.
I don't see anything special about it. A wave reduction converter. We might be able to use this. It's a specialized tool for dampening graviton flux waves.
Let me guess, Geordi's the only one who knows anything about this stuff. If you say anything out, if you use anybody else, they're going to be like, it doesn't look anything unusual.
A graviton probe. That could be useful when you're dealing with a gravitic power source.
Yeah, I deal with them every day, you know.
Pulse negators are used for canceling fluctuations in pulsed energy systems. That's a phase inverter coupling. It's for reconnecting multi-phase energy channels and correcting flux modulation problems.
Believe it or not, I remember that term from the show. I don't remember what it does, but I remember him talking about phase inverter couplings, or someone talking about it.
I don't think we'll need this plasma shunt. The main power source here is definitely not plasma-based.
Flux router?
A flux router is for really delicate work.
Yeah, he mentioned that before, too.
We did not come here for sightseeing. We did not.
No, he's not interested in stuff.
We did not.
Looks like a flux router of some kind.
Looks like a plasma shunt. It's a wave reduction converter. Looks like a phase inverter coupling. It's a graviton probe. It's a variable pulse negator.
He knows a lot about this stuff. Alright, so let's take everything. Never know what we're gonna use, or what we need to use.
It didn't work.
We took it all, right? Took the lot. Is there anything else to see in here? Because they were mentioning shutting off the power. Oh, there's a control panel here.
We can control power flow to the station from this console.
This auxiliary panel seems to control power flow.
Well, it's a little unfamiliar, but I think I can control the station's power flow from this panel.
The auxiliary power control station is still online.
Alright, well, I'm going to use Geordi to do this. Okay. Geordi, tell me what you know, because I don't know about this stuff. Initiate temporary shutdown. I figured we had to connect or configure these things in some way.
A lot of these systems are out. I can still cut the power to any of the four conduit groups, but not for long. I don't want to overload the system.
Hmm.
These controls are for emergency shutdown of the main power conduits.
Right.
I can shut down any of the conduits from here, but it'll be temporary.
From here, I think we can shut down the power to the conduits.
All right, Geordi, do your thing. Oh, shut down group one. All right, is that good then? Exit. Thing's still here.
I can't make it work with that.
Nah.
I can't make it work. I can't make it work.
Can't make it work with that.
I can't make it. I can't make it work. I can't make it.
Okay, these are our new equipment. Here's the old equipment.
I can't make it. I can't.
Am I supposed to combine any of this stuff?
I can't make it.
Maybe I'm supposed to use that on the control panel.
I can't make it.
Just trying everything, we're almost done.
I can't.
Alright, let's go back. Back in the engineering room.
I can't make.
Well, I probably have to go in it, use it.
I can't. I can't. I can't. I can't.
Yeah, no idea here.
I can't. I can't make. I can't.
So I've initiated temporary shutdown, and now what? So I'd use plasma shunt. Oh.
It didn't work.
Didn't work, man.
It didn't.
Funny how used ore doesn't work. Thoughts?
The only person I've seen so...
If we revive...
I can't just let that...
Back into the other room. Maybe they have some thoughts in there.
The only person I've seen...
I can't just...
If we revive...
Life support will fail if we don't...
Well... I don't know what to do about this crap right now. We can't... Walk the core control room? Okay, we haven't tried here yet. Oh! It won't let us go to core control room? Nope. Was he,
Geordi's been hurt. There's no...
I don't know why there's no need for it. Okay, so we got two turbo lifts?
Well? Well?
Or is that the same one? It won't let us go to core control. Administration of crew deck 2. How about not? Can I choose to cancel? No. Well, I can click that one. What about this one? No, same thing. Maybe if we blow it off in this section. Maybe Riker would be better at doing it. I don't know. Let's save. Because if she dies, I'll restore that to save. Itchy in the ear, gone. Use the phaser. Fire it here.
I don't think that's the best thing to do. I don't think that's... I don't think that's the... I don't think...
Fire it at the next room.
I don't think that...
He doesn't want to do it.
I don't think that's the...
Well, maybe we just need to use it on a really low setting. Low... Yeah, lowest setting, let's try. Right, aimed at...
Can't cut any closer without endangering her.
We did it on low setting. Okay, can we grab her now?
There's no way to get to her. We've got to move that cable.
Well, the cable is partially damaged now.
With all the damage this station... We can't risk it. If the cable shifts, it could crush her.
Who? Calling Crusher? She's right here.
It is too heavy.
He's the biggest, baddest guy here. Well, she's still alive, right?
That will not work.
Can we use the med kit on her now?
I can't do anything for her until we get that cable out of the way.
Well, we've kinda... Maybe we can use one of these new devices we found.
It's not working.
Oh, Geordi.
I can't make it work with that. I can't make it.
I don't want to hear that, Geordi. You make it work.
I can't make.
I've seen one of these things. You use this for, like, tilling the ground. Well.
I wouldn't try it. If that cable shifts, we could kill her.
So what the hell are we supposed to do with that? Move piece of cable.
I wouldn't try it.
It is too heavy.
Well, see. Seemed like we've gotten somewhere, haven't we? Let's use the phaser again. But now we've got piece of cable and data transfer line. So if we use the phaser on the piece of cable...
I don't think that's the best thing to do.
That might not be the best thing to do.
I don't think that's a good idea.
What are we supposed to do with piece of cable?
It is still too heavy to move.
It's still too large to move safely.
Unfortunately, we can't cut it any smaller.
Can't cut it any smaller.
We can't move this section. It's still too risky. But it might be small enough to transport.
We could transport it? Oh. Okay, so back to that other room. Room. Move to that way. Okay, let's see if we can use this thing. Lock on, energize.
It's a little risky, but I think we can use this transporter. It works just like ours. Lock on, then energize.
Makes sense.
It's a little...
The controls are simple. First acquire a lock, then energize.
Does everyone agree?
This panel has controls for locking onto a target and energizing the transporter.
It works just like any other transporter. Lock on and energize.
All right, then do the honors, Mr. Riker. Lock on. Data linked to sensors is damaged. Enter coordinates for transport. How do we find out the coordinates? Look at that exit, baby.
I can't just let that woman suffer. I can't just...
If we revive the injured woman...
I don't think that's such a good idea.
We're talking to the transporter panel.
Life support will fail if we don't get it stabilized soon. Once it fails, we won't have much time.
So we get coordinates. I guess we'll do that by using the tricorder on the thing, which we have to go all the way back then. Okay. Use tricorder on piece of cable.
It's a data transfer line. The end shows signs of contact with a phased energy beam.
Well, yeah, you were the one who used the phased energy beam.
This cable's built for handling information, not energy. I'm surprised it didn't just vaporize when it was hit.
No unusual readings.
Yeah. He's on himself. Can we just move over a little bit so we can... We can't transport her. Because that would probably kill her. Things aren't working right. Geordi.
That's a high-capacity data transfer cable. Probably a main communications line. Readings show damage characteristic of a phased plasma beam. I can't make it work with that.
Did I try these all?
I can't make it work.
On the piece of cable?
I can't make it.
How do I get the coordinates?
I can't just let...
There's no way to move that data cable ourselves. Maybe we could use the transporter. The readings we've taken are good enough for a transporter lock.
There you go. Readings are good for a transporter lock. Let's get the hell out of here. It's taking us forever to just walk back and forth. Okay. Use it again. Data cable. Numbers. Target locked, ready to energize. Energizing. It put it there.
I don't see anything special about it.
We did not come here for sightseeing.
There's nothing unusual.
Riker with this,
It didn't work.
Alright, so we can't get it, we can't use it. Let's just go. Back. Okay, we finally got this thing off her.
She's in bad shape. We've got to help her.
She looks bad. I hope we're not too late.
We must revive her. She may be able to tell us what happened.
Yeah, that Worf, always so caring.
At a glance, I'd say she's suffering from multiple fractures and shock. The bones in her legs may be shattered.
Okay. Do your goods here.
It's not working.
Not working? Gotta be working.
She's got multiple fractures in both legs. The bones in the lower part of her left leg are shattered. She's in shock and there's some internal bleeding.
Okay. Then let's help her. Not crush her.
That takes care of the worst of her injuries. She's coming around now.
Yay! Oh, what hit me? Anyone get the license number of that truck?
Anyone call? I can't do any more for her until we get her to sickbay.
Right.
She's stable now. We can evacuate her once we've lowered the station's shields.
Right.
She'll be all right for now. Let's see about that power core.
Oh, we gotta talk to her.
Her life is no longer in danger. However, she is still in no condition to be moved.
How do you feel?
I'll manage. You're from Starfleet, aren't you?
Seems like she's pretty.
Yes. We're from the Enterprise. Try not to move. I've stopped the bleeding and given you something for the pain, but your legs are in bad shape.
You're right. Multiple fractures, probable lacerations. I'm Ana Benyt, Chief Medical Officer.
Oh, well, there you go.
We've got a lot of wounded here, some worse off than me. How many can you evacuate?
One. No.
Our sickbay can handle any emergency cases. The rest we can beam down to the planet, but we can't begin transport until we lower the station's shields.
We can't do that until we stabilize or jettison the power core.
Alright, there's a large machine attached to one of the conduits. What is it? How many wounded are there? Yeah. This large machine question.
There's a large machine attached to one of the conduits down below. What is it?
I don't know what you're talking about. There shouldn't be anything down there but conduits and control panels.
It could be what caused the second impact and breached the hull. It's definitely armed.
I'm not involved in the energy experiments they do down there in engineering, but I do know there are no weapons on this station except the ones you're carrying. If it's armed, it isn't ours.
Okay, yep, intruder. How many wounded are there?
I can't give you an accurate count, but the first attack destroyed an entire wing. I was headed for sick bay when we were hit again.
Do you know who or what did this?
We never knew what hit us. There was an initial attack which lasted maybe 10 minutes. Later there was a hull breach and the power systems went crazy. I don't remember anything after that. I passed out.
Mm-hmm. What do you mean, power systems went crazy?
What did you mean when you said the power systems went crazy?
It's this insane experiment Dr. Greems and some of the other researchers put in place. A revolutionary power source. It's unstable enough to begin with. After sustaining damage like this, who knows what it'll do?
We've picked up some rather large power fluctuations. Is that normal?
How should I know? Those maniacs. You know what they've got down there? They plug the biggest research station in the quadrant into a singularity, a black hole.
Holy crap, really?
Then why the instability? I thought most singularities were stable.
Greems came up with some scheme to increase the energy output. Something about gravity waves. I don't know all the details, but it involved destabilizing the containment field.
Well, we have something that can deal with gravimetric something or other. Ask how she's feeling.
How are you feeling? Is there any pain?
I've been better, but I think I'm all right for now. Thanks again for your help.
What happened to the rest of the crew?
I can't believe they just left you here injured like this.
Most of them probably escaped when Commander Wilde gave the order to evacuate after the first attack. But I know many are trapped and can't reach the shuttle bays.
We'll get you beamed out of here as soon as possible. Don't try to move. You may aggravate your injuries.
Thank you, Doctor. I'm aware of that. I'll stay put.
Yeah. She's a med personnel.
Well, then I'll trust your professional judgment. We'll be back once we've restored life support and lowered the shields.
Wait a minute. Life support is failing? What's wrong with it? It wasn't damaged in the attack.
Main power is fluctuating so wildly that it's disrupting the life support systems.
I warned them about using an inherently unstable power source, but I never thought it would come to this.
Well, hindsight is 2020.
We can probably stabilize life support if we can switch to emergency power.
The only place you can do that is in station administration, and you'll need the security code to access the emergency systems.
Goody goody.
It's 334L42.
Okay, the game will probably know that automatically, but just in case I have to input it somewhere, I wrote it down.
Thank you.
Anytime. Good luck.
She sounds almost bored. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next episode and endure. In enduring, grow strong.